Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter with a new topic, that is food. As according to NCERT syllabus, your syllabus has been changed. So what is food and where does it come from? The word come from indicates that how we are just getting our food, where from where we can obtain our daily basis foods. That we are going to study in this chapter. What do you eat at home today? What you have taken home today in your breakfast or lunch time? What you will be taking tomorrow or what you have taken yesterday? Same thing. The food consists of different kinds at different times. Like that, in breakfast you are having bread, sandwiches and all that. And in lunchtime, you used to have rice, dal, vegetable curry or chapatis, etc. and so on. That what means in different types of having foodings, you have different kind of foods, isn't it? So, explaining this, we are going to explain two topics in this, in today's our topic. That is, first is food variety. And from where we are getting this food, the main sources or the materials of food variety. There seems to be such variety in the food that we eat. You know, now what happens according to our country, there are many states and those all have different kind of foodings. So what happens when we want to have a boiled rice? What we used to do? We used to take raw rice and mixed with water and boiled it. And after that, we used to prepare a dish of rice, plain rice, boiled rice, what we can say. But simply we cannot have it. So we, on the other hand, we used to have some dal, sabji or vegetable curry with that, so that we can have it properly. So we are getting a variety of foods. That means with boiled rice we are just having two chapatis also, dal also and some more. So just confirming this all ingredients, like that dal used to come, where dal used to come from, where the rice used to come from. If we are having vegetables, so where the vegetable is used to come from. So on this basis, what the ingredients are used to prepare them, we are going to study. So there is an activity. We are going to perform an activity. Choose some of the items and try to find out what ingredients are used to prepare these items. Okay, now from this activity, we are going to prepare, see how this food ingredients are prepared, using what ingredients. Like that, in first, roti and chapatis are there. So roti and chapati, both the words are familiar to you, isn't it? You used to have in your lunch also and dinner also. For preparing chapati or roti, your mama used to knead water and atta together, making a proper dough, and then after making a round rind chapatis, isn't it? So the next comes dal. This also you used to have. So in that, pulses, water, salt, oil, ghee, spices, all these are used. In that similar way, after confirming with your mother, you will just do this, fill up this options for sambar, idli, chicken, curry. Maybe you are not having, but you can guess and write the answer. That is not so quite that you can't do it. I think you are able to do. So after completing this activity, we know that from where we are getting this. So do we find some ingredients that are common for different food items? So here we are, the ingredients come from where we are getting such ingredients that we are having in our daily basis. So there comes the next topic, that is food materials and sources. Sources, what does this sources means? Sources means that from where you are getting such things, there must be one particular way to obtain those things which you want in your daily basis. That now it is not easy to for us to guess the sources of some of the ingredients that we listed in activity first, okay, but we can those things which we can see in daily life, that is foods, fruits, vegetables, from where we are getting such thing, of course from plants, isn't it? So from plants, if we are getting fruits and vegetables, the plant is the only source for getting rice, wheat, paddies of other maize, millets, barley, isn't it? All the whole grains which you all are eating used to come from plants. They are also another source, that is animals. From animals also you are getting some more things which you are going to prepare at home, which used to prepare at home, like that milk. From milk we are used to prepare ghee, cheese and paneer and all that, then butter, then next we used to have meat, egg. Those who are non-vegetarians, they used to have meat and all these things. So these all things are coming from animals, isn't it? Now from this activity, from the next activity, you can understand from where we are getting other ingredients and what are their main sources for providing us. Come to next. Now the second activity comes, that is ingredient used to prepare three times these items and sources. That is, idli is there, idli. So what does from what ingredients idli is prepared? You know that rice, urad dal, salt and water, these all the ingredients we use to make it for preparing idli. So from where it is coming? And that is the only plant, because rice used to come from plant, urad dal from plant, like same the chicken curry. So the second box you will write first what are the ingredients used for preparing chicken curry and from where we are getting the ingredients. I think animals also and plants are also there for just providing us this ingredients. In kheer, that you all know, what you are very much familiar with the kheer, because kheer is used to prepared by our mamas on traditional festivals. So you all have to eat, you like to eat kheer. So in kheer, first main ingredient is milk, and that is obtained by animals, yes or no? Yeah. So in kheer, if milk is the main ingredient, after that rice is also there. Without rice, how we can prepare kheer? And rice is prepared by plants. We get rice from plants, isn't it? Like that you will complete for dal and vegetable curry also. From this both the activities, we going to conclude that plants are the sources of food ingredients, like grams, cereals, fruits, vegetables, and animal providers, milk, meat products, eggs, etc. Like cows and buffaloes and goats are the some common animals which gives us milk, and milk and milk products like butter, cream, cheese and curds are used all over the world. So today's topic has been completed, but this is not the end of the chapter. In next topic we are going to study about more how plant and animals are the sources of for the food ingredients. From that that will be understand in the next topic. Thank you for today.